we first and foremost look for good team chemistry and build that team chemistry. That to me is probably the fundamental, most important thing we could do as a soccer team first and foremost, is making sure that, you know, they really become almost instantaneous best friends. And I think that has a lot to do with the way the girls treat each other with respect and just with an openness to basically bring new girls into the program and immediately accept them into the whole program. So I think certainly, you know, we do need players that can play this game. Maybe they've played either high-level club soccer or they've played high school, but we need girls that can basically edify and encourage each other first and foremost.
And I think even for us, the leaders, this past year, they did a great job of reminding all of us, you know, our primary goal to magnify Christ in what we're doing. So trying, making sure we're keeping things in perspective as we're putting our best effort forth on the field, in every other area, in academics, in every area, how can we magnify Christ?
For us, it's basically, it's demanding nothing but the best effort every time we train. You know, we just try to go into every training session with the attitude that this is game related. It's not just a drill. This is part of preparation for the matches to come. So I think it's really just a demand for the very best effort. And certainly that sometimes takes encouragement by the coach. It certainly takes encouragement by the players as well. I think the players give each other the best motivation when a practice is kind of grueling, kind of physically tough, and they just keep encouraging each other. And I think for our program, I think we try to build a culture where, again, the girls, you know, they're not going to get screamed at and yelled at. They're going to get encouraged to be the best players they can become. And that means they have to be mentally focused during practice. There's also the fun side. You know, it's a great experience to be together with a bunch of people that love the game that you love so much. And I think there certainly is the light side of the game as well that they get to participate in as well.
Our guys, they want to be challenged. You know, they want to be pushed. You know, so we will certainly still have fun. It'll be relaxing at times, and every now and again I'll joke with them or I'll smile, and they'll be looking at me like, "Coach, we don't know if you're serious or you're kidding right now." So we have a good time with the guys. You know, the road trips are fun. Time working out. Times at practice, and every now and again we'll change something up at practice and do something a little bit different, keep things exciting and interesting and fun. But we certainly want to push players just beyond a little bit what they're comfortable with. You know, if they're constantly coming out to practice and they're always comfortable, they're not really being challenged. So if you're comfortable with a specific technique or concept or whatever, how can we push you just beyond that comfort level to really push you to excel?
I think along that line, I think we have, at least on both teams, we have very, I think, elite-minded players. They love the game, they're passionate about it, and they really desire to become better players individually so that they can help the team as a whole. And most importantly, they do this for not only the team, but they do it for God's glory, and they really enjoy every facet of what they're doing as a team player within these programs.
The team excitement, a lot of it stems from leadership on the team. Whether we're up by goals or we're down by a few goals, regardless of how much time is on the clock, just that energy and that confidence that spills over from one player to the next. And when every player has that mentality, it's a positive thing. And having leaders on the team that are consistently doing that is vital to the success of the program.
We've got a new enough program right now that the excitement's still there, but it's really up to now the coaches and the teams to now start playing at a higher level. So as we become more competitive and that the higher level competition, I think will start driving continued excitement that I think the community has. But overall, we get great support from our BJU alumni and students and just the community at large. It's been a phenomenal experience, and I'm fairly confident that we're going to continue to see these supporting crowds and excitement that we see along with it. I think every coach has to have their own philosophy in how they're going to basically lead, how they're going to coach. Every coach is different. I'm gonna be what Christ would be to his disciples as far as, you know, in the coaching world. And it's more than just coaching. It's basically being a mentor, and it's certainly just being a friend when they need one. But can we take the players and keep them encouraged, build them, and just making sure that we're meeting all their needs?
It's certainly something constantly have to remind myself and ask myself, you know, what's my point in life? You know, if kids come here and they get a great education and they graduate and they're better at soccer, but I haven't taught them anything else, you know, again, by God's grace and through his leading, then what am I doing with my life? So that's one reason I'm into coaching. I've had coaches that have impacted my life, and it's a great privilege and opportunity to impact the lives of other young men. But I think students, as they're looking and considering schools, you know, where does God want them at? just again, fantastic facilities, fantastic education, and that desire. And it's certainly a Christian environment where we desire students that want to come here and want to grow in their walk with Christ. It's not that it's kind of sort of important, like soccer's the most important and the Christian values are kind of sort of important. You know, we want to strive to be excellent both with soccer and in challenging individuals to follow after Christ with their whole heart.
Man, I tell you what, this place is awesome. I mean, it's a great place to be, and I know our players really enjoy it.
Welcome to Alumni Stadium, home of the BJU Bruins! Tonight's game features the Columbia International University Rams and your BJU Bruins. The NCCAA and Bob Jones University promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives, as well as public intoxication, the consumption or possession of alcoholic beverages and tobacco products are grounds for removal from the site of competition and other disciplinary actions. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd ask that you please stand as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as Bruin Foundation board member David Jones opens tonight's match in a word of prayer.
Heavenly Father, thank you for this beautiful night that you've given us. Thank you for these teams, for these universities that they represent. We pray now, Father, that you would bless this time of fellowship and competition. Please be with the players, the officials, the coaches, and the fans. And I pray that everything that we do will bring honor and glory to you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
All right, Bruins fans, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. Starting tonight for the Columbia International University Rams, number 4, a sophomore defender, Abe Vasquez. Number 5 from Greenville, South Carolina, junior David Druin. A defender, number 9, sophomore Tyler Smith. Number 10, a freshman, Daniel Mealy. A freshman defender, number 11, Zach Hellman. Number 12, a freshman forward, Alex Hackett. Number 13, a sophomore forward, Mitchell Roberts. A junior midfielder, number 18, C.J. Jones. From Greensboro, North Carolina, number 20, freshman Daniel Mallard. From Heidelberg, Germany, a midfielder, number 21, Damian Patterson. And finally, the goalkeeper, number 24, Luke Brooks. And the Rams are coached by James Whitaker. All right, Bruins fans, let's give it up. Here's your 2013 Bob Jones University Bruins. Starting tonight for the Bruins, at goalkeeper, number 00, junior Joseph Wooster. Number 3, a senior midfielder, Jordan Allen. From Greenville, South Carolina, a senior midfielder, number 5, Caleb McKissick. Now please welcome sophomore forward, number 6, Matt Moore. From Delta, Pennsylvania, sophomore midfielder, number 8, Vincent Wilson. A junior defender, number 12, David Overlee. Number 13, another junior defender, Jonathan McLean. A biblical counseling major, he's a freshman. Please welcome number 16, Eric Moisent. Next, a senior humanities major, number 25, Cody Lehman. From Sterling Heights, Michigan, number 26, sophomore Travis Woodham. And last but not least, a sophomore midfielder, number 27, Ryan McCarty. And the Bruins are coached tonight by Jesse McCormick. All right, Bruins fans, it's game time. Let's make some noise.
And welcome to Bob Jones University Alumni Stadium. Gorgeous fall evening, and we're looking forward to a great soccer game tonight as the Bruins take on the Columbia International University Rams. I'm John Boone along with Nate Warwick, and yes, indeed, we're looking forward to a good game because, well, these teams are familiar with each other, Nate, even in the short history of the Bruins, the fourth time that they've played them, a win the first time last year, and then a draw down in Columbia, and then they lost in Columbia 2-0 earlier this year in a game they really thought they had a chance to win, just a penalty kick and a rebound shot for the two goals for Columbia, so they feel like they're right there with the Rams, and playing at home tonight, you know they got to be really up for this game.
Yeah, well, if you look at their game against them last year, they won 4-0, and all the people that scored are still on the team. There was a goal from Woodham, they had a goal from Moore, and then two from Ryan McCarty, some of those guys getting assists as well. And although the Rams have added some freshman talent, so have the Bruins, and that win was at home. Both the draw and the loss came on the road, and we know that the Bruins do really feed off the energy well here at home, but a big thing for them, this was definitely a case down in Columbia, is finishing their chances. Something we've seen with both Bruins teams this year. Sometimes they do it really well, and some games they have really, really struggled. This is a game they can't afford to struggle in. They need to create some opportunities, which they usually do okay at, but then they need to finish them, and that's something that we're looking for them to do today.
Both teams have guys leading their scoring that have scored about half of their goals or close to it. You know about Matt Moore and his 10. Well, how about the other team that has 43 goals, and yet they still have a guy that scored almost 20 of those, and Daniel Mallard, a sophomore, 20 goals. Amazing, and we'll keep an eye on him tonight.
Good team named Daniel, as Daniel Mealy leads the team with 15 assists.
Those are just very high numbers for the number of games they play. They have a record of 9-4-1.
Rams are on the attack already. That was a nice cross into the box, but Bruins able to clear it out of the way. Moore on the counterattack. Running down the line with it, keeps it in. Looking to cut to the inside. Drawing it across the box. And it looks like the Rams will be able to clear this out. But yeah, as a nice takeaway there on the outside. So you mentioned teams 1-1-1 against each other in their little over a year history. Played each other twice in September last year. Then, September and October last year, and September and now October this year.
And by all accounts, by the Bruins' accounts, and from what we've heard from the Columbia side, BJU was just all over the net in that game down there in Columbia earlier this year, and the stats would bear that out, shot-wise, corner kick-wise. They just couldn't get anything to go in. So that bad word that keeps haunting them, finishing, going to be a factor today.
Here's the corner, looping in. Ooh. Punched up, and that's going to go out of bounds. Question is, was it out of bounds? Nope, it's out of bounds after the kick, not before.
That was a good kick.
It's curling. It was looked to be above the hands of Brooks, which he has had a really, really good season. He's out of right here in Greenville. Has a 1.51 goals against average, about 75 save percentage, and 6 shutouts this year. Woodham with it. Remember, he scored the first goal against them last year in that home game. And both McCarty and Roberts pointing the opposite directions.
You talked about Brooks. I'm sorry, Nate. You talk about Brooks, the goaltender. He was an NCCAA Student Athlete of the Week earlier this month, and the shutout against the Bruins was part of the reason why he got it. He shut out Concordia in the next game to pick up those honors. So, yes, he is a very sharp goaltender in more ways than one.
Should have used that last game when the goaltender's last name was Sharp. Here we go. Throw in coming, and that's going to be knocked out of bounds by McCarty. Throw in coming for the Rams. Going down the near sideline, gets it into Roberts. Trying to turn the corner with it. Pressured hard by Overly. In the middle, that's going to be taken away by Moisson. Bruins coming off of a tough 4-1 loss against Georgia Gwinnett on Tuesday. Grizzlies really played a fantastic game. Bruins lose it on the far side. And Rams lose it out of bounds, so we'll have a throw-in coming for the Bruins.
Yeah, that was a tough game. They got the early goal, took the early lead. But then it worked a little bit by a very good team.
Bruins tried to penetrate that one inside, but three different blue jersey players all around. Didn't go anywhere. Very hard to go 1-on-3. Seen some people do it, but it's very hard to do.
Yes, the odds are kind of against you.
Got a whistle against the Bruins, so Rams will get a free kick. Neither team really dominating here early on. Nice hustle there from Roberts to take the ball away. Shot from outside, wide left.
Wow, that was a bullet.
Mooster made a nice dive at it, but fortunately it went wide. Took that one from pretty far out, but if that had been to the right, we might be looking at a 1-0 score right now. Shorter goal kick. Missed a couple players there. working with it is Patterson. Go out. Wilson with the throw. Moore heading it through. Oh, almost got it all the way to Woodham. Good pressure, but it's going to go back to the back line of defense to Vasquez for the Rams. Looking to push it up. More pressuring. Drop back. Woodham on him now. Able to get out to the outside. Good defense. Nice step in front. Passes a little bit errant, though. Rams still trying to work it down that far sideline. Bruins will let it roll out for throwing.
Neither team, in this first five-plus minutes anyway, able to put any structure together on offense.
Yeah, no really maintained possessions. A lot of throw-ins, though. Another one coming up here for the Bruins. Wilson's got some room to work. Not completely out of the gaze of Patterson, though. He's kind of keeping an eye on him down here. McCarty with it. Gets around to the edge, and he lost it. Good pressure, hard from behind. Send forward. Lehman right there. Good defense. Into Eric Moisen in the middle. Drop back one more time. Set all the way back. Wilson back again. Moisen tried to get it into Allen, but lost it. Watch for a shot right here. Oh, good pet. Oh, good attempted pass. The outside. In case you're curious, it was C.J. Jones and Daniel Mealy who scored against the Bruins earlier this year. Moore fighting through all the way into the box. Passes it through and a diving save.
Wow.
I'm not even sure how Brooks got his hand up there, but he did and punches it up over the top.
Great job by Moore, and Woodham just about put it home. Moore just working all the way in to set that play up.
Yeah, if Brooks' hand wasn't there, I'm pretty sure that was in the net. Another corner, nice another case. Good one. Header, straight down into the ground. Popping out to the outside of the box, and this will be cleared away. How about that drive by Moore, though? He just worked it all the way in there. That's actually still in bounds. Now it finally rolls out. Quite the clear, though. Exactly what it was supposed to do. Eight time up to, you know, get the Rams back in position. Force the Bruins back out of the scoring zone. It's a good clear. Cutting into the inside. Good drop back to Woodham. Woodham's got some space. Here we go. Here's Allen. Thought about a shot. Gives it over. Looped into the middle. He's offside. No, he's not. Travis Woodham. I think all the Rams just stopped playing for the same reason that I thought. I thought he was offside, so did they. He was not. Buries it home, and it's 1-0 Bruins.
Yeah, you're right. It appeared like they stopped. Travis Woodham from Vincent Wilson. Bruins get the first goal. Again, an early one, Nate. About just almost exactly 8 minutes into the game.
Guess that's a textbook example of play to the whistle. Nice contest actually rolled off the back there of Jones. It's a little bit of deja vu for the Bruins. It's like last time Rams came here to the stadium, Woodham scores first. That's got to feel good for the Bruins, less than 9 minutes into the game, doing what they could not do last time these teams met. That was such a funny play. Like, I think he was, he must have been onside when the kick happened, because that's when offside is measured, but by the time the ball got over there, it was he and the goalie one-on-one. And he finished. It's one of those times you kind of wish you had replay. There's the throw in. Hit immediately out of the air. Nice defense there. Tap back, and the Bruins offense will reset. Got an offside call. So Brooks will kick it away. Nice header by Lehman. Still looking for his first header for a goal. It'll come eventually, I'm sure. Ooh, nice move by Wilson. Good touch. Pressured from behind, put into the middle. Lehman's got some room to work, switches fields. McLean sends it up through the middle. Went all the way through. Moore could have controlled that. He would have had a nice turn and go, but that was a tough one as it came whizzing by him just as he was turning around. Drop kick from Brooks.
Wow.
Drilled that one back the other way, and now Woodham's in a foot race for it. Able to get to it. Couldn't save it, though. Great hustle by Woodham. Got the first touch, but then couldn't get the second on it before it rolled over the end line. That was quite the one touch from back in the Bruins zone, though. It was just cranked right back the other way. Nice header forward. Tapped in the middle. Roberts was trying to get it somewhere. To the outside. Moore with it. Dances through the defense. Finally kicked away. Weren't going to let him penetrate all the way through that time. Nice control by the Bruins. Now they're going to send it back into their own zone themselves. 11 minutes in. BJU Bruins leading the CIU Rams. 1-0. Of a Travis Woodham goal. Not really sure who that send was to. Nobody was really forward. Brooks will take it himself. Pretty good goal kick. Going to be controlled by Jones. Taken away, though. Here's Woodham. Drop back, squirts it through. A little bit of miscommunication there, but looks like they will challenge for it right back. McCarty got it. Bunching up just a little bit there in the offensive zone right now. A few too many people around the ball. There are some good touches right there. Nice pass. McCarty feeds it to the outside. Chance to cross it in. Try to dribble it in. That will be a throw-in right near the corner. Some good help defense by the Rams there. Throw-in coming. Clean, there it is, all the way across, punched up in the air, and then headed toward out of the zone. Big defensive play. Brooks punched that straight up, and then the clear never happened. Bruins had a chance to strike it in, but timely defense.
Getting a lot of corner kicks early in this one.
Well, last couple of both looked really nice. This one looks good, too. Mm. Top part of the box, just over the head. Another good clear. Looks a lot like the last one. It'll go out a little sooner, though, closer to midfield. Overly throws this one in pretty much right away. Gets it out to Lehman. Over to McLean. Allen took a little while to get under control, but got it. Good pass to Wilson. First touch went too far away, though. Now Jones with it. Good pullback. Gives it back to Hellman. Sending it across. And they're going to whistle hack it on that one.
Yeah, McLean going for the header and got kind of pushed out of the way. As Hackett was going for it as well.
Hackett was also the one that had that laser of a shot earlier. Side, trying to keep it in on the far touchline. Battling for it. Looks like they got out of it with it, but they'll just put it across the middle and Rams will pick it up. Nice hustle there from Vincent Wilson as he takes it away. Oh, but nope, we're going to have a whistle. Good hustle, though. Kicked into play by Smith. Outside, nice cross. But it's not going to be close enough for Jones to get anything on it. Goal kick coming for Wooster. Just about 15 minutes into this one. Bruins lead 1-0 over the Columbia International University.
They seem to have brought quite a few fans with them.
Well, it is an in-state rivalry, so to speak.
Yeah, just an hour and a half down the road.
If it's fair to say we have a rivalry after 1 year. I don't know. Are you allowed to say that or not?
Sure.
We're going to say it anyway. That's good. That should be Bruins. Yep. Kicked off of Robertson. Or Roberts. Well, we've got a substitution coming on, so they'll do that throw in over again. Who's coming out? Looks like it'll be Vincent Wilson. Having a seat. Is that Andrew Moisant, I think? Far side?
Yep. 24.
Tried to get the throw into Woodham. Didn't work. Overly able to get it up to McCarty. Pass is just a little far for him. McKissick in as well. Lehman will track this one down and drop it back to McLean. Pressured by Roberts. Kicks out to the outside. Nice job by the Rams cutting off a lot of the options. That's a good through pass, though. They can hit McKissick. He's got a nice running lane. They're going up through the middle right now. Pass to Woodham. Woodham's got a man on the outside. Lost it. Good control, though, by Eric Moisant. Sends it up. There's the guy on the outside. Is that Andrew, I think? Mm-hmm. Cutting it back in. Trying to maintain possession and lost it. Good takeaway by the Rams. Charging up on the counter. Good pass. Sent all the way down the line. And they're actually going to keep that in play. Send it back into the middle. Overly with time. Into the middle. That was almost dangerous as Mealy was there. Sent down to Jones. Trying something to do with it. Pops it back into the middle. Patterson drops it out to the outside.
Bruins have been doing a good job clogging up the midfield so far. They're not letting the Rams get anything going. Here's a little bit of a send as Mallard finally got involved in the play. They've been keeping him out of it. That's one of the few touches he's had here so far in the first half.
Yep. 5'10 sophomore out of Greensboro, North Carolina. That was Jones on the shot, by the way, that was errant. As you said, absolutely gorgeous night, though. The temperature's wonderful, pretty much full moon out. No wind. Great evening for soccer.
And for Fandemonium.
Yes. Although it could be pouring down rain.
Yes,
so it'd be a great night for Fandemonium. Here we go. Can Moore find McKissick? There he is. He's been looking for that one for a little while. McKissick trying to turn it around. Lost it, though. Moore. Nice physical play. Got right back on it. Crosses it in.
Oh.
Right by the goal. It's McCarty.
Oh,
it's deflected. And then attempting to power it out was Patterson. Deflects off the Bruins, and it'll be a goal kick.
Matt Moore with just another great pass. And McCarty just couldn't find an open lane to shoot it through.
There were three or four defenders between him and Brooks, and there was probably, what, 5 feet? Six feet?
Frustrating for McCarty, but if they keep that up, they're going to see some good results.
Probably 6 feet in distance and in anatomy. McCarty trying again. Here we go. He's gets taken down. And so we will get a free kick just a few yards outside the 18. It's a great chance for the Bruins if they can capitalize on it. Both Moore and Eric Moisant, who's been the one taking the corner kicks, both them are by the ball. Curling toward the outside of the box. Header for Lehman. Over the top, sliding and just barely missing. Oh, great attempt there. I think that was that Jordan Allen?
Sliding through there at the end, yeah.
Lehman's header went all the way across the goal. That was McKissick.
But another great setup. And, boy, Moisant's on with his kick so far tonight. Beautiful.
Yeah, Lehman's header wasn't off by much, and McKissick almost got a piece of it. Here's Jones again. He's been threatening throughout the day. So tap over. Knocked over by Fowler. Far side. They cross it in. Good defense. Lehman right there. Fowler trying again. This one's pushed forward. Got a little bit of space with it. Turn and go. Up to Moore. Takes his time with it. Tried to push it through to Woodham on the outside, but that lane was shut down. Rams working up near midfield. So that was Hellman with it. Good pressure still from Moore and Woodham up front. Pass got a little bit away. Moore's going to take it down the outside. Dribbling through the traffic. Pops it up, trying to get it to Woodham. Good defense. Headed back into play, though. It's Moore again. Turn, and once again, good solid placement. Defense holding their ground.
Ball still in as Moore went flying out of bounds.
Still Bruins ball, though. Going to drop it back. Smart play. Smart play. A little bit of a switch fill and a reset at the same time. Trying to squeeze it through. Woodham. It's deflected back. Pass over to McKissick. He's got some room with it if he can curl it in. There's the cross right to the middle. Off the chest. Off the shot. Bounces up.
Rebound
and then bicycle kicked away. Woodham charging in there to try to get the finish. I think it was Moisant with the original kick. And McCarty was working against Fowler there. Fowler was the one with the kick as well. Slide. Moisant keeps it in. Forward.
Nice.
Still working with it. Across the middle to Moore. Shot! Just wide right. Well, the Bruins are putting pressure upon pressure on the Rams right now.
They sure are, and they're just winning every ball right now. Really playing well here as we reach the midway point of the first half with a 1-0 lead. And Moore showed you again his strength there. He just kind of flicked it off the front part of his foot and still a rocket just wide.
Well, credit the Rams defense. They've kept quite a few goals from, or quite a few shots from reaching Brooks and goal. And even so, Bruins still with the 1-0 lead. Woodham able to get himself past the defense off of the pass from Wilson. Was able to beat Brooks one-on-one. That's the difference right now, but earlier we said nobody really had momentum, and I think you can definitely say the Bruins have it all right now. Better watch what I say, though. Here come the Rams. Into the middle. Shot. Bounces twice, and Wooster's there. This came from Mealy. Mentioned he's one of the goal scorers from last time. To Woodham, headed forward, trying to get to Moore. Well, Moore got it, but he's going to roll too far, and Brooks able to get there. Moore was going 1-on-6 if you include the goalie.
And as you would say,
Hellman. Up through the middle. Jones chasing it down. Lehman's going to get there first. Oh, dribbling through and not able to keep it. Almost looked like he tweaked his ankle there at the end of that run.
Appears to be all right. But that was an awkward landing.
And McCarty right in this case that it is a Bruins throw in. Both players immediately point opposite directions, as is typical. Moore able to get into the middle. Woodham going for it. Nice defensive play there by Druin. Just over 20 minutes to go here in the first half. Bruins lead 1-0. Nice pass into the middle. Lots of space to work with. McCarty pushes it forward. Got out to the outside. Tried to cross it, and Bruins will get another corner.
Yet another corner.
First one from this side, though, I think.
I think you're right. They did have the free kick from this side, but it's the first corner.
Got Moore actually taking the kick this time. Taps it in, then the cross, header, toward the gap, shot, into the arms of Brooks. Moisant almost made it 2-0 there. That was a nice setup play once again.
Just tried to tap it the other way, away from where Brooks was coming, but credit Brooks for the save.
Well, he got a pretty rousing cheer when his name was called. Oh, nice defensive play. Well done.
Good defense there.
That was Andrew Moisant, who had it taken away. And a credit, Tyler Smith. He's the sweeper back there for the Rams. He's had some really nice plays today. Good hustle there as Fowler just able to get it away over to Hellman. Hellman's got some space. He's pops it in the middle, drop back. Mealy getting it once again, working against two different Bruins. Tried to fight through the pressure, but Bruins end up with it. Sent to Moore, drops it back. Good one touch. Brings it across midfield again. Drop it back into their own territory for a bit. Curling into the middle to McCarty. McCarty's got a couple Rams on him. Trying to send it up through the middle. Good defense. You can tell the Bruins are fighting for every possession. Moore dropped it off, but nobody ran in through the space. Send forward for the Rams. Good look. Foot race on the outside. And McLean knocked over, and that'll be a free kick.
So far, the Rams not getting any more than one-on-one situations with the defense. They're not even getting one-on-one on the goalie. The defense has been a wall back there.
I think they only have one shot on goal, and that one came from pretty far out. It wasn't really a close shot. Nice clear there by Smith. Sent forward. This is a dangerous play right here. Good defense. Coming over to help. Sent back up the line, but it's going to be taken by Hellman. Spin move with it. Trying to squeak it through. He was trying to get that to Hackett. That pass is going to be past Jones on the outside. Got another substitution coming in. Just under 17 minutes to go, and McCarty has had a hard-fought half. Had some shots on goal. He's going to take a seat. And it looks like Sexton in. Throw in comes to Woodham. Woodham bringing it back into the middle. Sent forward. Kind of a layout header there. Keep it away from Moore and get it to Brooks, so did its intended purpose. Brooks sends it. Only Bruins in that area, though. Moisant fighting for it. Good pass into the middle. Nice defense, though, by Patterson. Stimmied the attack there for a bit. Down to Caleb Moisant. Pressured hard by Jones. He's going to go all the way back to Wooster. Back to Overly. Pressure, Up the middle, got to Woodham. Drop back for Eric Moisant. Sending it out to the outside. Nice send. Good chance to cross this or drive it. Slid out, shot, and that's going to be way over the top as Woodham was kind of falling down as he shot it. Not really able to get his body around it at all.
Fans, the Bruins men's soccer staff would like to invite student athletes in 9th through 12th grade to attend soccer camp the week of July 14th through the 19th. Standard team and player camp will be held from the 14th to the 17th, then elite camp for experienced players with a desire to play at the next level will be held the 17th through the 19th. The camps offer a unique mix of a qualified coaching staff while incorporating biblical principles to encourage athletes to develop their God-given ability.
Moore nearly got up to Sexton on that last possession. Beatles looks like he's offside. He's coming back on, though, as the ball is now going the other way. Jones pressured off of it by Moisant. Nice pass there by Hackett. Over to Jones. Jones with the cross. That's a good one. Header is high up in the air. Diving save by Wooster. Hackett with a nice header toward the right side of the goal. Wooster there. Big time save to keep this thing 1-0.
You're not kidding.
Which is saying something, because I do that quite a lot.
Yeah. That was a dangerous play in there. Hackett did a good job.
That was a nice redirect. Ball was coming toward him, and he put it back the other direction. Wooster with the quick reflexes, though. Nothing against him, but I think Brooks' one-armed save there in the first couple minutes is still save of the game so far.
Yeah.
That was quite impressive. A big save from Wooster there as well. Here's Overly. He's got Moisant. Didn't go to it, and very nearly taken away by Jones. Easy to see how Jones is one of the goal scorers. He definitely hustles to the ball. But thankfully, none of the Rams have been able to post a goal so far this game. Coming up the middle. There's the send. McLean should be able to cut that one off, and indeed he does. Forces the throw in. Inside 13 minutes to go here in the first half. Bruins with a 1-0 lead over the Rams.
Nate, we could have a little bigger of an audience tonight as the Bruins are partnering with the National Soccer Coaches Association of America, the NSCAA, to webcast this match. They're picking it up at NSCAATV.com as well as the way everybody does on BJUBruins.com. And NSCAA is founded in 1941, the largest soccer coaches organization serving members at every level of the game.
Sorry to interrupt you, but that was a great send into the middle, a shot. Big time defensive play by Overly coming up with the heading stop. Ooh. Bruins trying to clear it, still can't. Rams mounting a nice offensive attack. Here's another cross. This one's way too deep for Jones to do anything with, though. He's going to have to run down just to keep it from going out of bounds. Sent back. Nice control by Hellman. He sends this one back inside again. Good step in front. Moisant out to the outside. Able to get it to Caleb Moisant. Yeah, it's going to be another throw in for the Bruins.
Going to back him up a little bit there with the throw. Yeah, the Bruins got just a little bit careless back there on their defensive end. They've been so good in this first half, but they still got the goose egg on the scoreboard for the Rams.
Throwing from Hellman, goes into the middle to Smith. Gets it up a little bit to Fowler. Over to Patterson, up the middle. A little bit of a misplay there.
That's Mallard with it.
Look out. Good cross into the middle. That's rolling through, and Wooster's going to call off the three Bruin defenders who are all racing to it. That's a good problem. Here's Sexton. And that's going to roll out of bounds. Going to give it up to Moisant. Moore pops into the middle. Sexton, nice header. First clear attempt there by Smith was denied. Moore once again showing that strength, just muscling off the ball. A little bit of an errant pass as Beatles went one way and the ball went the other. Trying to turn and go. Bruins right there, though. Keep it in along the far touch line. Good pressure, trying to get to Beatles. Finally gets it. Back into the middle. Rams had a really nice offensive push, but they look pretty harried there in that defense. And turn it over very quickly once they get into the Bruins zone.
Bruins, meanwhile, we heard Coach McCormick talk about last game. They seem to have these little lulls where they don't do too much. Seem to be going through one of them right now. Let's see if they can start to get the possession back and do something on offense.
Love to see him get a couple more goals.
Oh, yeah, at least a couple, right?
Had so many opportunities there in the first 15 minutes or so.
Yeah.
Really crashing the net hard. More substitutions coming in. Fowler coming out for the Rams.
Looks like Joel Cave coming in. Or is it her?
I believe that's her.
That's
yep,
Daniel
that is her.
Her, yeah.
Yep. Cave has the bluish cleats. Watch, one of these days they're going to switch up cleats on me just to throw me off. But it's also number 21, and that's also Daniel. There's the goal kick. 8.5 minutes to go. BJU Bruins 1, Columbia International University Rams 0 here so far. Rams throw in, far touch line. Been an exciting game so far, especially those first 15 minutes or so.
If you missed it, the Bruins scored right at the 8-minute mark. Travis Woodham putting the ball home.
And coming up sooner than it feels like it will, halftime. Have some cool stuff going on. It's senior night, so we'll have some senior presentations. We'll have interview with Coach McCormick, and then up here in the booth, we'll have interview with Coach Ring, the men's basketball team, also the Bruins athletic director. Bruins clear it down the line. Rams trying to push it right back. Great physical contest going on for the ball right now. It's really nice to see players fight for each and every possession. And both teams doing that right now.
Seems like the Rams picked up the pace here from earlier in the game. And the Bruins certainly don't want to get caught giving up a goal right before the half.
Seems like the university efforts to get a lot of people out to the stadium has worked.
Well, you're not kidding. That when we got here before the game, there was already a decent crowd, and now it's just packed out.
Yeah, you even have a good group of people just standing along the track. Bruins in control right now. Up 1-0 and controlling the ball in their own half. Sent up the middle. Not quite able to get to Beatles. Headed forward. Smith's going to let them go through to Brooks. Bruins trying to control it here on the far side of the field. As you said, not a lot of offensive push from them here lately. They've had some attempts to get it inside, but no real good looks here in the last several minutes. Patterson dropping it back. Smith will have to hustle back before Moisen gets there. And they're not able to save it. It'll be a throw-in. Audrey Moison with it. Stutter stepping, taken away by the Rams. Sent forward, and that'll be out of bounds.
Fans, show your colors by visiting the Bruins merchandise store. Go to shopbjubruins.com for Bruins shirts, hats, jackets. Yes, it is that time of year. And other items, that's shopbjubruins.com. They've always got some good deals on there as well.
Coming up through the middle, and that's going to, should go all the way through to Wooster. Yep. Good job. Mealy trying to orchestrate an attack there. Offside. Haven't had too many of those today.
No.
Something that really plagued the Bruins a lot the first time these teams met. They got called offside a bunch. Not so today. Better presence. Here's Beatles. No, he has some pop to his kick. Sending this one across, and that's going to be deflected away. Nice header back into the zone. Beatles switching fields. All the way over to Andrew Moison. Nice chest. Forward. That's going to be drilled out for a throw-in. Throw-in coming for the Bruins as we tick down inside 4 minutes. And that'll be deflected out of bounds for a goal kick. Well, Bruins have put together a solid first half so far. Put a ton of pressure on early. It's tapered off here lately. But they're still definitely pressing on the attack, just haven't had the sustained pressure that we saw earlier on.
Yeah, I think the Rams kind of tightened up that midfield a little bit. They're still not getting a whole lot of offensive pressure, but they're not allowing the Bruins to set up like they were earlier.
Throw-in is right down the line, but on the ensuing turn attempt, it is a turnover. Substitution coming in for the Bruins. Pulling John Wilson into the middle as Micah Nifuku. Haven't seen him a whole lot this year.
Right.
Good to see him out here. Not able to keep it in on the far touchline, so we'll have a throw-in pretty much right at midfield. And see if they can do something here in these last couple minutes of the half. Nice header to save it, and then Kinifugu not quite able to keep it in.
Beatles was tracking that down like he was a center fielder and did a good job to keep it in, but they couldn't keep the possession.
Patterson sends it across over to Vasquez. Vasquez working through the middle. Good luck finding Giroux. I'm sorry, that is Hellman. Jones with it. Great pressure from behind. Nifuku putting some good D on. Good turn, drop back. Pressing up the sideline. They're just flying down that touchline.
It's going
to be a throw-in for the Bruins.
Is Caleb Moison over there going up the line?
Not sure, but that's going to be a shot all the way into Brooks.
But man, he was flying.
Minute 10 here in the first half. Once again, just a reminder, we have an interview with Coach McCormick coming up at the half, along with the senior ceremony here for the Bruin men. Had that for the ladies on Tuesday. And then we'll have an interview with Coach Ring up here in the press box. Definitely stick around during halftime, which is coming up here soon. 45 seconds. Bruins with it. And with a 1-0 lead. Sent forward. Popped into the middle. Smith clearing it back toward the box. Punch forward for Sexton. Sexton driving through. And Play on. Punch in the middle, headed back, 25 seconds, and that will be a throw-in for the Rams. Well, they aren't exactly racing to the ball. I think they're content to go into the half with the 1-0 deficit. Now they go down the line with it. Popped forward. Nobody even pressuring, and that will do it for the half. Your BJU Bruins with a 1-0 lead.
Well, Nate, they came out flying, scored within the first 8 minutes, did the Bruins. Really took it to the Rams at Columbia International University and got that 1-0 lead. And Columbia responded a little bit, started playing a little tougher, but the Bruin defense just too tough, as they were just denying everything, just about every good scoring opportunity. Only one time where Wooster was really tested. And the Bruins got a lot of chances early, not so many late, but that 1-0 lead at the half has got to feel good.
Now, in just a little bit, we will have the interview with Coach McCormick, but just one more reminder after that, don't go anywhere because we will have a ceremony for the seniors. But stick around, but here we are. Johnny Gimmick, go ahead and take it away.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Coach, let's talk a little bit about that first half. We got a goal early. What do you think were some of the attributing factors from the offensive standpoint of getting that early goal?
We came out with some intensity, which was a good thing. Went in 50-50 balls. Could have been a little bit more composed. So first 25 minutes, a lot of good intensity, step into the ball, and then it really dropped off a bit. We can't have that, so it's got to be better the second half.
All right, second half, I know the energy is high. I mean, we've been looking forward to this game most of the week. What are you telling you guys at halftime to kind of keep them calm and composed for the second half?
We've got to settle down and keep the ball. We've been giving away the ball away too much. So we've got to settle down, make sure we're keeping it, playing our game, and just taking care of the ball.
Real quick, Coach, talk about these seniors and what they've meant to your team this year.
Oh, yeah. Without question, all these seniors have brought a whole lot to the team on and off the field, have been tremendous leaders, and just God's really blessed us to have such a quality group of seniors.
All right. Thanks, Coach. Back to you guys.
All righty. And so once again, your halftime score, Bruins 1, Rams 0. And now we'll send you right back down to the field and to our PA announcer, Forrest Brazil, for the senior presentation.
And gentlemen, at this time, please direct your attention to the field as we recognize our 2013 Bruins seniors. The Bruins have 9 seniors on their team this season. First, number 0, John Weiser. John is the son of Jim and Linda Weiser. John is an engineering major. He's from Painesville, Ohio. After graduation, John plans to begin work in mechanical engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, number 0, John Weiser. Next, number 11, Micah Inafuku. Micah is the son of Dan and Ruth Inafuku. Micah is a business administration major. He's from Waianae, Hawaii. After graduation, Micah plans to return home to Hawaii and start working. Number 11, Micah Inafuku. Next, number 1, Cam Lawson. Cam is the son of Darren and Sarah Lawson. Cam is a pastoral studies major from Greenville, South Carolina. After graduation, Cam plans to attend seminary at Southern Baptist Theological Seminary with the hopes of being a church planter out west. Ladies and gentlemen, number 1, Cam Lawson. Next, we have number 23, Joel Cave. Joel is the son of Jim and Sue Cave. Joel is an accounting major from Spencerville, Ohio. After graduation, Joel plans to work in the Greenville area and coach on the side. Ladies and gentlemen, number 23, Joel Cave. Next, number 7, Stephen Lovelace. Stephen is the son of Timothy and Beth Lovelace. Stephen is an accounting major from Adrian, Michigan. After graduation, Stephen will be getting married in August, and he hopes to join an accounting firm after that. Ladies and gentlemen, number 7, Stephen Lovelace. Next, we have number 25, Cody Lehman. Cody is the son of John and Susan Lehman. Cody is a humanities major from Greenville, South Carolina. After graduating this December, Cody will begin working as an athletics director and teacher and will be getting married to Bruins soccer player Sarah Porch in April. Let's hear it for number 25, Cody Lehman. Next, number 5, Caleb McKissick. Caleb is the son of Steve and Tanya McKissick. Caleb is a health, fitness, and recreation major from Greenville, South Carolina. After graduation, Caleb hopes to pursue a teaching career in physical education and coaching soccer. Ladies and gentlemen, number 5, Caleb McKissick. Next, we have number 9, Mark Bonikowski. Mark is the son of Andrew and Naomi Bonikowski. Mark is a communications major from Zagama, Spain. After graduation, Mark plans to get a job with oral interpretation at a hospital or a law firm. Ladies and gentlemen, number 9, Mark Bonikowski. And finally, we have number 3, Jordan Allen. Jordan is the son of Ron and Janice Allen. Jordan is a Bible major. He's from Matthews, North Carolina. And after graduation, Jordan plans to work at the Wilds of New England this summer before he returns for grad school in the fall. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for number 3, Jordan Allen. The Bruins coaching staff and BJU family would like to thank these graduating seniors for helping lay the foundation to use the platform of athletics to glorify God by pursuing competitive excellence and Christian service. At this time, we would ask you to stand as Bruins Athletics Director Neil Ring prays for the seniors of the men's soccer team.
Let's pray. Our Father, we thank you for your goodness to us. Thank you for these men. Thank you for their hard work. Thank you for blessing them with physical health and safety. Lord, we pray that you would bless them tonight as they continue this match. And then, Lord, we pray for their future as they pursue what you want them to do. We pray that you would guide them to the places that you would have them to be. May they be men of character, men of integrity, men of God, and may they make a difference in this world. Thank you for their impact in our program, on our university. In Jesus' name, amen.
The great thing about BJ is that I'm constantly challenged by my friends and by my teachers.
My teachers aren't content just to leave me where I am.
They very much want to come alongside us. They don't just give the lecture and walk away from us, but they encourage us.
To get to come together and to worship the Lord as a body of believers, it's such a blessing and such an encouragement.
Everything I do is focused on Christ and on the gospel. Whether it's in class or whether it's on a sports field, whatever it may be, it's for His sake.
Thanks so much for taking the time to look into the Bruins webcast. We'd like to especially extend a special welcome to those of you that are watching from the watching the webcast from that endeavor. We thank you so much. This is Bob Jones University, and we're playing Columbia International tonight. I'm Johnny Gambit, the Sports Information Director, and with me is Neil Ring. You just heard him with his dedicatory prayer for our seniors, and we certainly appreciate all that Neil does. But we wanted to talk a little bit for those fans at home about summer camps. I know this is the time of year where parents and people are starting to already look ahead to summer plans. And we thought it'd be a good opportunity for us to talk about our summer camps. You run a couple of basketball camps, and then we have soccer, we have volleyball, we have a couple of different camps that are going on this summer. And in particular, what makes our camps different from other camps?
Well, I think we try to make sure that we provide not only a physical challenge, but we also work hard on developing the whole person. And we always provide some type of a spiritual component. Most of our camps provide both
you know, individual, small group, and then group sessions where we're just we're not spending our whole time in camp doing spiritual things, but we do include that. We kind of use that in between morning, afternoon, evening to give our guys and ladies a chance to rest as well as give them a chance to hear some practical application of God's word to their life.
Let's talk a little bit about basketball camp in general. I mean, since that's what your expertise is, you know, take me through the sports side of the camp. You know, what are the specific drills that you're going to have your people working on, and even the different levels of camp that you guys run?
Yeah, I think it's good for us to recognize different athletes. For example, we had a young man here this last summer that is a rising junior and just really did a great job in camp and has actually become one of our, you know, leading recruits for the future. So that's a big part of it. It's also an opportunity for fun. Some young men come and just want to play basketball. We do a lot of fundamental instruction. We do a lot of teaching of the game, and then we try to give multiple opportunities for the players to put that into practice. And then we do a lot of fun stuff, you know, dunk competitions, three-point shootouts, hotspot competition, you know, free throw champions, all of those things, and then three-on-three, one-on-one, five-on-five. We keep the week very, very full, and, you know, we have a great pool. We use the pool a lot, and we try to make it a great week away from home, away from, you know, from the summer. Maybe they're working and they come and they just get a week to come, and we try to make it a great time for them.
You mentioned a little bit about the facilities that we have here. I want to touch on that a little bit, just even from Alumni Stadium here to the Davis Fieldhouse. Talk a little bit about the experience that a camper would have coming and taking part in a camp through our facilities.
Yeah, we've been blessed. God has really blessed us with some really nice facilities, from the air-conditioned dorms to air-conditioned fieldhouse, and obviously, you know, soccer, there's not a lot of air conditioning there, but they do some training inside, some classroom work, et cetera. But, you know, we try to utilize the facilities that God has given us, and we try to make sure that each of the campers that come gets a chance to experience a little bit of what it's like to be a student-athlete, to be a student. We recognize that not every student, you know, that comes and participates in camp is going to play collegiate athletics, but we want them to come and get a taste of what it's like to be a student here and the opportunities they have, the facilities we have. And we bring our admission staff over and try to interact, answer questions, take them and show them our multimedia, you know, just to try to give them an opportunity to see, you know, not just the athletic facilities and the coaches, but to interact and meet a lot of the folks here on campus.
One of the unique things about our camp as well is you use your own personal players as well to help in the counselors and being involved as some of the coaches in the camp. Talk about why you think that's important with the interaction between a student athlete who's here and a possible student athlete in the future.
Right. No, that's a big plus. Camps that have, you know, the athletes from the team and the coaches, you know, that's a tremendous blessing for me to have a great staff. And then to have some great players who are willing to, you know, give up a week and come back and work in our camp. And it's a great opportunity for a young man or young woman coming in to interact with a college student who goes through the rigors of, you know, daily life in college and ask them questions. And that's why we want them in the dorm with them. You know, we want them to have a chance to, you know, to find out what's it really like. You know, is it really fun? Is it hard? And our student athletes are able to give them a true picture, and then they get to work with our coaching staff. And, you know, we're preparing, you know, collegiate athletes to play, and so they get a taste of what it's like to maybe prepare as a collegiate athlete. And some love it. Some, you know, boy, it's just a little too much. You know, I don't really want to work, you know, and try to become a college athlete. I just want to play basketball. So, you know, we're tweaking some of our camps a little bit, so that we have kind of camps for, you know, for all levels, whether it's the junior camps that we started last year or elite camps for those who are, you know, they're really interested and they're able to play at a college level, or if it's just a camp for the students to come and participate and have a good time.
Well, we certainly hope you will consider Bob Jones University for sports camps this summer. There's all the information you'll want to have on that on bjubruins.com. I will say the one confirmed for you soccer enthusiasts out there, July 14th through the 17th is our standard regular soccer camp, and then elite camp is from the 17th through the 19th. So that's July 14th through the 17th. And 17th through the 19th of 2014 coming up next summer. Stay tuned. The guys will be right back to bring you the second half.
We want to assist students in reaching their academic goals, whether it be through raising a grade or a project, paper. We're here to help them with study skills, note-taking skills, time management, reading textbooks, things that will help students to do better in their classes. We offer one-on-one academic coaching. We also offer our writing center, which will help students develop their writing skills. We have our academic accommodations, which is for students who have learning disabilities. Our tutor referral, which helps students who are looking for a specific content tutor. Our study groups, which help students in many of the courses here right on campus. And we have our educational technologies, which help students with checking materials out that will help them with projects or presentations, and it also includes a computer lab. Coaching is for any student. If you want to improve your grade, whether it be from a B to an A or from a C to a B, coaching is definitely a place for you. Our coaches will meet once or twice a week, whatever you would like to meet, and they do an action plan with the student, and they constantly go over the action plan to see how the student is doing. All of the resources that we offer are free to students because we want them to come and use the resources that we have for them to become successful in their college careers.
Back at Alumni Stadium, we're set for second half action. The Bruins and the Rams of Columbia International University have been a good game so far, Nate. The Bruins getting the lone goal about 8 minutes into the game. Travis Woodham with the score. And as you heard the coach going into halftime, a little bit of a lull there in the second part of the first half. They're going to have to pick up the energy again in the second half to come out of here with a victory.
Yeah, they cannot afford to sit on their heels too long, or this Rams team will make them pay. You mentioned many times all it takes is one bad bounce, one good shot, and this is a brand new ball game. Here's McKissick into the middle, headed forward, trying to get to Woodham, couldn't do it. Oh, that was a dangerous play back into the middle. Able to fight through it and
we'll finally call it.
Yep. That is Joel Cave out there now, by the way.
One of the seniors that was honored at halftime. 9 on the Bruins team this year.
There's the send forward all the way through. Into the middle. Oh, bad touch. That was a good pass. Woodham just couldn't handle it. We'll get a throw in though for the Bruins. Drop back. Send from outside. It's going to bounce one in into the arms of Brooks.
That previous pass from the outside came from Inafuku, who we mentioned, we haven't mentioned his name very much this year, but he came on late in the first half and he's out there to start the second half.
One of the seniors as well, as is McKissick, who has the ball now. Able to get to Eric Moisant, nice play. Sent forward for more, headed back. McCarty getting there. McCarty had 2 goals last time these teams played each other. Plus an assist to boot. Nice redirect there. Bruins looking to move it up this near side. Cave with it.
Yeah,
not able to keep it in.
Took it out of bounds, yeah. Mentioned earlier on, if you're just joining us again, these teams played 3 times. Bruins won here last year. 4-0, a draw on the road, 1-1, and then lost in Columbia earlier this year, 2-0. So this is the tiebreaker in the early going of this series.
McCarty not able to chase that one down, so it'll be a throw in. From Hellman, ends up settling down by Patterson. Gives it over to Fowler, who's back in the game. To the outside. Fowler, nice pass into space to Patterson. Down to Hellman, he's got some room to work. Into the middle, and Wooster's going to take that off one bounce.
Saw that thing kind of knuckling towards him. He actually had to take a step back the other way to get in front of it.
Woodham drops it back. Now back up to him on the outside. Punching it into the middle. Moore looking to cross this in. Good cross shot, wide right.
Nafuko's right there.
It was a good run. He just was blanketed by defenders on either side.
Head coach for the Rams, James Whitaker. No stranger to BJU or, for that matter, the teams that they play, in that he did his undergraduate work here and his graduate work in town at Furman, and coached Clearwater to those championships we were telling you about the other day when they were up here. He's the one that coached them to the 2009 and 10 national championship.
Woodham fighting through this one, working against Patterson. Send across the middle. Big defense from Vasquez. McKissick settles it. Another cross. Gonna go all the way. Header. Diving save. Shot. Goal! Matt Moore! And I thought for sure Brooks had that in his hands. It popped right back out. And Moore was just waiting to bang that home.
You don't see that very often. Looked like he had totally crowded. Give Matt Moore credit for not giving up on the play. And as soon as that ball came free, he stuck it home for his 11th goal of the season.
What have we talked about? Beginning of halves, that one coming 4-18 into the second half. And here we go. Rams trying to counter. But big goal puts them up 2-0. And once again, just funny in the deja vu kind of way that it is, last time these teams played right here, Woodham got the first goal and Moore got the second. And 1 year later, Woodham got the first goal and Moore got the second. Oh, here's Moore. He's got some room to try another one. He's being pressured hard from behind. Good defense there by David Druin. They're going to say it went off of Moore last, so even better defense than I initially thought.
Actually, they're going to call Moore for a foul.
Oh, okay. Well, it was good defense by Drew in either way.
Yep.
Moore has been very physical tonight, has won a lot of possessions, created a lot of turnovers that way. McCarty with it, trying to get it out and around, fighting against a couple different players, and finally it's going to come to rest with Mealy. Tried to get into the middle to Fowler, but couldn't do it. Neely gets it back here.
The Bruins certainly don't want to be back on their heels now because the Rams are going to start playing with a little more desperation, down two goals.
Fowler shot, that's going to be over the top. You got that pass from Mallard, who such a dangerous player, 20 goals in 14 games. By the way, Columbia International is 9-4-1 on the year. That one tie coming in their last game where they were actually down 2-0, as they are today, came back to tie it. Here's a pass, both Moore and Woodham. Moore, good defense, stays with it. Oh. Shot, deflected. Big save from Brooks as that'll be kicked out to the far touchline. Nice shot from Matt Moore, and Brooks comes up with another huge save.
And that was a good point you brought up about their last game. They were down 2-0 to North Greenville and did come back to tie that up. They went to double overtime. It remained a draw.
On the ground is Charles Fowler, the freshman defender from Walhalla, South Carolina.
It's one of my favorite places in South Carolina, just to say, Walhalla.
Are you from there?
No. But a number of my students, they play schools in that area, and it's Walhalla. It's just fun to say. And it looks like he'll be okay as he walks to the, now jogs to the sideline, so doesn't look like a serious injury there. Clock did stop with 38:20 to go here in the second half.
going back to that record for a second, although they are 9-4-1, they're only 3-3 on the road. So they've played well this season, but struggled a bit when they are away from Columbia. And right now, they're looking at a mirror image of earlier this year when they took home a 2-0 victory over the Bruins in Columbia. And right now, though there's still lots of time left, the Bruins are up 2-0 over the Rams. Here we go, nice offensive push. Passed up through the middle, nice clear, popped up. Fighting for it. Bruins gonna win it, send it up to Moore. Nice one touch back. And McKissick's going to hit that off of Druin. Sent forward, here's Moore. Good pressure from Smith on the outside. And it's just going to be tapped out of bounds by Moore. Couldn't get around the corner, good defense by Smith.
He's a little upset with himself there, Matt Moore was.
He's had some great runs, and then of course he is the goal scorer here this half. Is what looked like a sure save for Brooks. Popped out right at Moore's feet, and he popped it into the net. McKissick not quite able to save that one. Moore almost got to it. Hellman, lots of room in the middle, so he gives it up to Patterson. Sent forward, and there's nobody there. Not sure what was happening on that play, but Wooster will get it. That's a good send. Nice pass on the outside to Woodham, too. He's being pressured hard, though. Good defense. Popped forward. Should be able to be tracked down there and sent up the middle. It's a nice pass there to Hellman. Up the middle, going for Mallard there. Right down the line, there's Mallard, good defense. Joel Cave denying that one. Throw in coming for the Rams, gonna be taken by Hellman. Throw toward the touch, or toward the goal line, rather. Pressure, Mallard, double teamed. So this is dangerous. That's a good chance for Roberts to shoot.
Oh, look at that.
Just over the corner.
That's a nice looking shot from where he was. All or nothing, obviously, but boy, that looked pretty good.
Roberts scored 3 goals this year. It's from Burkina Faso. Not a name we get to say very often. Although you should try saying it sometime. It's a lot of fun. Just say it right there at home. Burkina Faso has a fun ring to it. Here we go. Rams on the attack again. And that was short-lived as the Bruins get a throw-in. Get another one a little farther up. And we've got another man down over on the Rams side. He's quick enough to get up, though. They don't have to stop the clock. So if they have to stop the clock, you have to be subbed out. Nice header there. Racing for it, but good defense. Bruins able to seal that off. We'll have a throw-in coming up on the far touchline.
It's Lehman again back there. He's been a brick wall all season long.
Bruins being given a little bit of space to work with. Drilled down the middle. A good switch, but McKissick not able to control it soon enough. Fighting hard with Mallard. Punch forward for Woodham. But nice job by Druin closing that off. And great hustle by Woodham. He nearly got in front of Brooks' goal kick.
Woodham is been hustling the entire game. He's been all over the field. And, of course, he does have a goal.
Yep. He had a great year last year and just had a solid one again this year. McKissick thought about Woodham, but sees that's a little bit too guarded there.
He just kept moving up the line. That'll be Joel Cave throwing it in from.
Yeah, well, he probably did move, what, a good, back. Like, yeah. At least 10 anyway.
Yeah.
Some room to work. Up the middle. Moore, nice control. He's got McKissick. Great through. What can McKissick do with it? Into the inside. He's into the box. He's double teamed. Dropped it back, but to the wrong player as Roberts takes it away. He's trying to get it to Allen. Roberts still dribbling with it. Gives it up to Mallard. Working against Cave. Dropped over. It's a good look to Hackett. Across the middle and big defensive clear there. Those passes across the middle always kind of make you hold your breath for a second because really easy for the ball to get tapped or the goalie's not. Hellman with the throw in to Mallard. Trying to cut it in. Good help D. Hellman tries to send it across the middle and Moisant says no. Woodham with it. Up to Moisant. He's got Moore on the run. He's onside.
No, he's not. That was close. Awful close. That's one of those you could argue again where he is when the ball is kicked. Looked like he was even, but it's a judgment call.
This is why I'm not an official quickly. On our goal, I originally thought our guy was offside. And on our breakaway, I thought he was onside. It's just the way it goes. Good header. But they have a much better view than I do usually because they're looking right down the line. Pass to Moore, a little bit too slow. Good hustle. That's going to be drilled way out. Over on this near touch line, they're going to give it up to Druin for the throw in.
Nice.
Or that was Hellman, rather, not Druin. Druin was the one who just knocked that out of bounds. So now Moore will have it. Into the middle. Back out to McKissick. Cross. All the way to the other side of the field. Both players miss
right
it.
Through everybody.
Talk about a through ball. Sent up the middle. Nice job by Lehman. Coming up and pressuring that. Oh, there's those one-touch passes that when they get him going are just a thing of beauty to watch. And they're all on target where they're supposed to be. Controlled well, just like that. Clinic. No. Here's Moore. Can he make it two? Yes, he can! 3-0 Bruins. Talk about a passing clinic. I think they had about 15 passes in a row that were all spot on, dead on controlled. Couldn't ask for a much more perfect possession than that one.
More perfect, yeah, you got it. Matt Moore with his second goal of the night. And that, as you said, that was a thing of beauty. That's the one you take on video and show how it's done in a clinic.
Every pass, they knew where they were going with it. On target, quick. Well controlled. Now Mealy trying to answer. Shot, and Wooster there again. McCarty unable to get it forward to Moore. Hellman with the throw in. Intercepted by McCarty. Into the middle, knocked away by Mealy. McCarty got a piece of it, but a little bit of a piece of Mealy as well. Helps him back up. I think it'll be Smith taking the kick. Just past midfield. Inside 30 minutes to go here in the game. Bruins with a 3-0 lead. That's a great send. And Wooster able to elevate and grab it. And that last possession was just amazing. the type of thing that you go over in practice and you say, this is the way we want to do it, and that's the way to execute it right there. Here's Moore coming up again. Sent forward. It's McCarty. Tried to pass into the middle. Good defense. McCarty still with it. Going around the outside to Moore. Back to McCarty. Nice. Sent across the middle. Right to the foot of McKissick. And it's, I think that's a deflection off. Yes. No, it's not. Just came off the wrong part of the foot. Thought it might have gotten tipped with the weird way it curved off, but it's hit the wrong part of McKissick's foot.
Yeah, he's looking for that top corner, but like you said, it just kind of sailed on him.
Even there, though, nice setup. Coming with the header. Sending it forward, coming into the middle. Allen gonna get a little bit of a shove from behind. Quickly putting the ball into play. Trying to keep as much of an advantage as they can. Moisant trying to be muscled off the ball. By the way, it's good to see Fowler back out there and commits the foul right there.
Yeah, he's all right.
Thought about a send in, pass it to the outside instead. Drop down the line for the corner. Good slide, able to maintain possession though. Working into the inside, and that's going to be kicked out of bounds, and it will be a corner.
Well, the Bruins are keeping up that energy level right now that Coach McCormick was talking about. They came out with it in the first half and kind of went into a little bit of a lull, but they've come out here in the second half and have kept it up through the first, well, almost 20 minutes now, and have two goals to show for it and a 3-0 lead.
Both of them coming from Matt Moore. One on a just kind of fluky play where Brooks just wasn't able to hold on to it. The other one on near perfect setup. That's a good corner, but it is cleared out. Bruins maintain possession though. Bring it back in. Here's another send over the head of Matt. Able to maintain possession though. We've got a
foul on Lehman.
Lehman, yep. Not sure what that was, but it is a foul.
And it was a hustle foul.
Here we go. Here come the Rams with the kick. Bruins winning those 50-50 balls again. Something they were doing a lot of, trying for the header. Lehman denies that opportunity. Bruins not able to clear it out of the zone yet. Looks like they'll do it here, though. Passes a little bit behind Gunther. He's able to get to it, though. He's been playing a good bit in the second halves lately.
Yes, he has.
Kind of a second half spark, so to speak.
We've mentioned it before, the Bruins are pretty deep on that bench. There's not much drop-off. I mean, Matt Moore is one of a kind on offense. It's not quite the same when he's not in there leading the offense, but everybody else is pretty good. Not much drop off at all, offensively or defensively.
Bruins trying to work the give and go on the outside corner. A lot of pressure, and I don't even know how they got that pass off, but Rams did. Into the middle, it's Moore fighting through it.
Oh, couldn't get the shot.
Good defense. He was looking for the hat trick. There's the send. Nice catch. Brooks making sure that one didn't fall through. Yes, he had Bruins coming through for the header.
Bruins are just playing relentless right now.
Well, that's what they did at the beginning of the first half, and it yielded the goal and lots of near goals. And that's what Coach McCormick said. They need to keep that up all the second half.
And that's their style. You don't see them go into a shell with a 3-0 lead.
Moore just whipped that one around. This looks like he's got some good space to work with. Can't tell who that is on the outside, though. Shot in, it's wide right. Goal kick.
Another Ram is slow to get up.
That is Drew in that time. Is that Caleb Moisen on the far side?
Couldn't see if it's 26 or 28. It's either Woodham or It's well, not 28 Woodham, up here, so it's not 28.
Okay. Not sure what just happened.
It is Woodham.
Anyway, 24-21 to go. Bruins lead 3-0.
It did stop the clock for the injury.
Been a rough night for the Rams. They've had a few guys go down. Fortunately, none of them have looked serious.
And keep in mind, which makes this, at least so far, one of the more impressive performances by the Bruins. This is a team that's 9-4-1 that they're playing, and a team that has beaten some of the teams that the Bruins have played by more than what the Bruins have beaten them, and really deserve that 9-4-1 record, but the Bruins have just taken it to them tonight.
Not to mention the fact that they beat the Bruins earlier this year.
Right. And I think a lot of that is on the mind of the Bruins because, of course, one of those goals was a penalty kick, and the other was on a rebound after a save by Wooster. So they felt like they should have done better, and they're doing better tonight.
Yeah, they actually, in the couple years, they've not allowed a goal at home. Mm-hmm. Won 4-0 last year, and they're up 3-0 here on the road. The 1-1 tie and the 0-2 loss. Cave back up the middle. Bit of a weird deflection there as Sexton, or Allen tried to get out of the way. Fighting through. Look at all the Bruins just clogging that middle. Had seven guys back there near the box. Trying to force Gunther off the ball, and he's just still going with it. Finally lost it. Mealy able to take it away. Gives it over to Roberts. And that will be a throw-in for the Rams. Looks like they've got a substitute ready to come in. Not quite yet, apparently. Popped up in the air, and nice job by Cave. Look at that jump, he just got up. Cave still with it. Into the middle to Moisson, or Sexton rather. Ramble will kick it out of bounds. Throw in coming for the Bruins. Well, good night to be a Bruins fan. Tons of people packing out the stadium here. 3-0 lead for the Bruins. A couple really nice goals. Lots of energy from the crowd. Here's Gunther. Passing out to the corner. It's Allen, sent into the middle. Smith got in the way. Gunther into the middle. Sexton trying to fight through it. Another clear from Smith. That's going to be a pressure from behind. That was on her that time. A little bit too much body there. Hellman with it for the Rams. Down the side, nice defense by Gunther. Or Cave. No, Gunther. I had it right the first time. They're kind of right next to each other. Roberts coming out. Looks like Giroux in. Fowler with the cross. Rams do get to it. They'll have to drop it back. Another send. Nice header. And Bruins clear it out. Back to Vasquez, he'll reset it for the Rams. Trying to work it into the middle. It will be a Rams throw-in. Time ticking down, just over 20 minutes to go here in regulation. Bruins looking solid so far, 3-0 lead. Got a goal from Woodham about 8 minutes into the first half. The rest of the half was pretty quiet. Had a couple more good opportunities early, but nothing really big. That's a takedown, an accidental, but a takedown, and so that was against Mallard. It's going to be just outside the box, fortunately not inside the box. Certainly don't want a repeat of the penalty kick scenario.
But a good opportunity here for the Rams.
like a four-man wall for the Bruins. Oh, nope, down to three. Referee going to back them up a little bit. It will be either Mealy or Mallard. One of the Daniels taking the kick. It will be Mallard. Nope, Mealy. Not a bad cross, but Bruins the first ones to it. Sending up to Moore, trying to get a quick counterattack. It's a two-on-one. Here's the run, having to slow it down a bit. It's Gunther. Tapped it forward. Got it up. Still maintains possession. Cross. Far side's going to be too far. They still got it, though. Cross back, a little bit of room for Sexton. Looping it across. No Bruins there. Moore off the hands, and then Brooks able to grab it. Bit of a misplay by the Rams defense. Gave Moore a shot just inside the 18. Brooks up to the task this time. Hellman with it. Popped into the middle. Smith sending it forward. Over the head of Giroux. Now it's coming back to him. Sliding save attempt, and it's not going to happen.
Fans, check out the Bruins website for all the latest information on your BJU Bruins. That's bjubruins.com. There you'll be able to see the results of the games, feature stories on players and coaches, and so much more. A lot of video, a lot of audio on there. That's bjubruins.com. And, of course, now with basketball season coming up, just all kinds of things going on.
I've really been impressed by the way the Bruins have stuck with possessions even when they've been under heavy pressure, and they've been able to apply some heavy pressure themselves. Can't say that about every game. Good clear out to the outside. Gonna be a throw-in coming in for the Rams. Like to see him hold on to a shutout here. Mm-hmm. Definitely earned it so far. They can't afford to let it up. Nice job by Bruins with the block there. Some space shot, and that's up over the top. With the goal kick. Close to midfield. Sexton trying to lead the counter. And he gets another bump from Fowler. Good pressure. Nice run on the outside. Chance to cross. Keeps it in. Deflected out to the outside. Nice job by the Rams D. Now they're pushing their own counter. Nice slide. Well attacked there. Up the middle, and too many white jerseys. With the exception of an occasional lapse here and there, the Bruins defense has been suffocating tonight.
Yeah, very few shots, let alone real scoring opportunities.
Nice hustle by Gunther to get back to that one. Drops it back to Cave. Switch field, nicely done. Down the line. Fighting through, here we go. Into the middle of the Sexton, drops it back. Back to Sexton, shot blocked. Allen pulled it back, but couldn't get it back to Sexton. It's just cleared away, not really so much a send as much as just a clear. Cave went down hard on that one.
Yes, he did. Usually you see him get the better of the physical confrontations, but not that time.
He and Lehman were right there, though, able to help each other out. No matter how sturdy you are, if you get off balance, it's really easy to push you over. send up through the middle. Nice job by Brooks calling that off. Kind of a mixed bag of a game for him. He's had a couple absolutely outstanding saves. One right near the beginning of the game and another fine diving one earlier. Mallard running on it. Gonna let Wooster get that one. Lehman trying to block Mallard off from getting to it.
Yeah, he ran some good interference there. Yeah, you're right about Brooks. He certainly would like to have that one goal back. Not a whole lot he could do about the other two. And yeah, he's made some fantastic saves.
Yeah, that second one, it was sure looked like it was right in his hands to me. Look at the replay again later, but looked like he just dropped it. Bruins fighting through. Nice slide. That will be a corner kick. Bruins have had quite a few of those today.
Yeah, a ton in the first half. Fans, don't forget to be sure to follow the Bruins on social media. Like the Bruin Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter at BJU Bruins. During the game, be sure to tweet, post your pictures of you cheering your Bruins on to victory. Use social media and cheer on the Bruins.
Cross is deflected up in the air by Smith. Headed away. Shot back toward the zone, but it is wide right. We'll have a goal kick. Beatles came into the game for the Bruins and also one other guy on the far side of the field.
I guess they only had four corner kicks in the first half, but it sure seemed like a lot more than that. They kind of all came in a short amount of time, I think.
Yeah, all in that first 20 minutes or so. Or at least most of them, anyway. So they really got a lot of their pressure, and I think this half they've done a better job of not letting that pressure drop off. As Coach McCormick said, there was almost a palpable difference about midway through the first half where the energy just kind of stopped, or at least decreased greatly. Adrian Moisant fighting for it, almost got it away. Hellman able to successfully get it over to Smith.
Yeah, they've been very steady in the second half, and you know, after they got the second goal, you saw the Rams really try to push it some more to get back in it, and then it seems that third goal really deflated the Rams a bit, and they've been kind of stuck back in their own end quite a bit since then. So even the Bruins are in control.
Even when they've had an RN, kind of like right now, it's a lot of those kind of things. He's
way
offside.
Offside, yeah.
Where they really haven't been able to mount any kind of sustained attack. It's kind of like what our attack has looked like in some games, quite frankly, where we kind of rely on, you know, one good play. You know,
right, some one-on-one plays, some long sends, hoping for something, but never really setting it up on offense.
But that has not been the case for the Bruins tonight. Every goal they have set up, even that one that went through the hands, it went through the hands after a really, really nice setup.
Yep, and Moore had to be right there. I mean, he would have been able to corral that right back into his hands, but Moore was right there at the perfect time. As soon as he dropped it, it was in the back of the net.
We've got a goalie change.
Get the senior in there. Cam Lawson.
Yeah, two of the three netminders will be leaving the team. John Weiser being the other. Wooster will still be around. Theoretically, anyway. We hope so. Just over 11 minutes to go here. BJU Bruins with a nice 3-0 lead. And Bruins have done a splendid job of keeping up the energy, keeping up the pressure, not letting the Rams get a foothold. And it has paid off. Got a goal from Woodham early on in the first half, and then Matt Moore tacked two more onto his impressive season so far.
12 on the year for him now.
I don't want to mess up my math this time. This is the 13th game, right?
Yes.
So almost
still
a goal
just
per game.
Just missing, yeah, a goal per game.
We'll also have to score two goals again next game. You know, I guess guess we can live with that.
Well, speaking of that, we can let you know that the next game will be the last home game. So if you're wanting to come out and see the Bruins, it will be on Tuesday night as they take on Reinhardt University, actually Tuesday evening. It's a 5 o'clock game. And then they finish out on the road the last three regular season games.
Owen tried to cross it in. It's deflected out. So we'll have a throw in. Had Mallard working with him, and Bruins have really, really shut Mallard down. He has not had any good opportunities at all.
Right.
Cross into the middle. Good defense once again. Second time we've seen that where one has looked like it's going to squirt all the way through, and then one of the defenders steps up, denies the opportunity. Always on your toes. Here's Druin. Dropping back to Smith. Back up the middle to Hackett. Sent forward.
Oh.
Pushed it through. One on one. Can he finish? Dribbles it through.
Oh,
and misses wide left.
Oh.
He was pressured hard from behind by Druin and could not get it done.
That last touch just a little too far for Wilson.
What a run. Got one-on-one, then tapped it to the side of Brooks, but then could not sneak it inside the post.
He put his hands on his thighs. Oh, man, so such a good opportunity. That was big-time one-on-one.
I thought he had that one for sure.
And that was John Wilson, by the way, and he's got it again.
Big opportunity. What's killer is when those happen in a 0-0
yes.
or a 1-0 or one of those games. It's not quite as crucial in a game like the one that's being played right now. But
you can shake it off a little bit at least.
At least you don't feel like you lost the game for your team or anything that way. Hellman puts it through the middle. Bruins helping out again. Cave able to work it through. Fighting for it. Good pass to Hellman. Back inside. Mallard has it knocked away from him by Beatles. Thrown into the middle. Headed out to the outside. Good hustle. Nice pass to Mallard. Then back to Hackett again. Back to Mallard. Back to Hackett. Crossed.
Oh.
Punch just over the goal. That was a nice setup. They had some really good working back and forth and then popped it into the middle. I think that was Roberts. Took the shot, and he had one that went just over the corner last half, too, or earlier this half.
Yep.
Over that top left corner, it was just a foot or two over. And now we are down to 7 minutes left. Here is the Bruins look to even up their record. 5-6-1 right now, trying to improve that a bit. We've had a lot of close games. Last game against the Grizzlies was the only time all year they've allowed more than 2 goals in a game. And through the 12 games leading up to this, they've only allowed 16 goals. So pretty impressive goals against average for the team.
Yeah, and that translates for Wooster anyway at a 1.45, I think it is, for the year. He's had a great year. Of course, Cam Lawson finishing this one out on senior night. But he has played 90 minutes coming in without giving up a goal.
Beatles looks like he'll be coming out.
Now they're going to switch goaltenders again, Nate.
And the other senior getting a little bit of playing time. John Weiser. I remember watching a game that he played where his Rams were playing the Beta Patriots. And I say this in the nicest way possible. It was the best 10 goals allowed performance I've ever seen in my life. The Rams just weren't able to really defend Beta at all. It was really controlling. We'll stop that for a second as Mallard is pushing up with it here, looking to get a shot off. Drops it back. That's a good drop. Oh, better defense, though. Somehow got away with it. Still dribbling around. Right inside the box, pushing in. Good cutback. Really lost the defender there for a bit. Still fighting. Down to about 5 minutes to go. Send into the middle. Popped up. Controlled by Hellman. Shot. Blocked. Here come the Bruins the other way. Passed out to McKissick. McKissick sends it forward. It's McCarty. Into the middle. That's going to be booted away. John Wilson tried to get a piece of that one. Couldn't quite do it. Mallard going to drop it back. Gets it back to him after giving it to Roberts. Druin gets it now. Pressing forward against her. Shot, and that's going to be wide right. Weiser lets it go.
All right, so finish the story. I can't wait to hear the best ever 10 goals against performance.
Well, the Rams were just, it was a rough year for them. And Beta had it in the Rams half pretty much the entire set of minutes. And they were able to get 10 goals over that, but I think Weiser probably had at least 20 saves.
Just a shooting gallery, huh?
He made some very impressive one-on-one stops. Druin tried to take that one right out of midair, misplayed it. But yeah, he had some very impressive play. He was a big reason why they didn't lose worse in a lot of games. Of course, talk about Beta, here's Matt Moore. Going hard. Oh,
boy, that was an all or nothing stop for the defense there, because if he goes down and Moore gets by him, see you later.
Yeah, Patterson able to keep it. It was Roberts. Yeah, it was the reason they didn't give up a whole lot more goals than they did in a lot of games. Definitely earned his spot on the Bruins squad. It didn't play a whole lot, but there he is sliding out to grab that one. Make no mistake, he definitely earned the spot.
And it shows you, too, that the goals against average is more speaking for the defense a lot of times than it is for the goaltender.
Although sometimes, as we've seen, Wooster make a couple really nice plays today.
Yeah, it's a combination.
Because it just barely couldn't save it. So close. So close. Substitution. 2.5 minutes to go. Bruins looking to hopefully seal up a shutout. Leading 3-0 over the Columbia, I've done that twice now, Columbia International Rams. And I think I can say fairly definitively that third goal is the best goal I have seen all year. The setup to that was, I'm sure Coach McCormick could find something, but as far as I'm concerned, that was best setup I've seen this year.
I mean, they could have given four different players assists on that play. That's how pretty that was, because it was bang, 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 in.
Here comes the kick. Curling in. That was actually a really, really nice Weiser diving for it, popping out to the middle. Overran it a bit, otherwise that would have been a good chance for a shot. Here's Moore. That was a nice corner. Have it going back the other way. See how far up Rams will get it. 1 minute, 14 seconds to go. Bruins got a goal from Travis Woodham, two from Matt Moore. And for the vast majority of the game, it's really been the Bruins. Especially in the second half. Up to Moore. Oh, that's a great pass. Another chance for Wilson. Can he capitalize this? Yes, he can! With less than a minute to go, the Bruins make it 4-0. And Matt Moore gets an assist to add to his night as well.
Oh, Wilson deserved that one, didn't he? After putting the effort and just missing previously. Got it to him. He put it in the back of the net. 4-0.
Yeah, he wasn't going to risk dribbling it all the way through this time. He's like, I'm
shooting.
Taking my open look while I can, and definitely converted on that one. It looked a lot like Matt Moore's goal earlier, just kept it right on the ground, low and hard, left side of the net.
We do want to remind you before we go, Plan First Asset Management and Financial Planning is a proud sponsor of your BJU Bruins. Visit them today, planfirst.com. Be sure to listen to Talking Money. It's a weekly call-in radio program every Saturday morning. So in other words, tomorrow morning at 10 on Talk 94.5 FM here locally. Plan First offers solid financial counsel and sound investment planning. You can give them a call at 864-233-7405 or go online at planfirst.com.
So we talked about how kind of the irony of some of this game with last year. These two teams met, and Woodham scored first, and then Moore, and that happened again this time. And the final score is exactly the same. Your BJU Bruins coming away with a big victory here at home on senior night, scoring four goals and holding the Columbia International University Rams scoreless. Big win for the guys. Four goals is good for them, really. Capitalized on almost every chance, really. That breakaway by Wilson, the only good chance they had, they didn't capitalize on. A lot of things to hold their heads up about. This game always looked to improve, but a couple really, really excellent plays there.
And a win against a quality team, and of course, the way the second half went, second half, they just played really, really well. No lulls at all. Good energy. A 4-0 victory for the Bruins. All right, well, all day, the Bob Jones University student body has been wearing their Bruin shirts, showing their support for the athletic teams. And right now, that crowd is going to be heading over to the Davis Fieldhouse for Bruin Fandemonium. The basketball teams will be introduced. There'll be lots more going on with a lot of enthusiasm and noise. And our first basketball webcast 1 week from tonight, or 2 weeks, I'm sorry, Friday, November 1st, as the women and men play Johnson University. 2 weeks from tonight, webcast times. 5 and 7. One more home game for the men is their home on Tuesday night, this coming Tuesday, against Reinhardt. Tonight's crew included journalism, mass communication students Maria Irvin and Dawn Mellinger. They were joined on camera with staff member Jim Jordan. Down on the webcast trailer is chief engineer Jeff Carr and director, my cousin, Dan Boone. I'm John Boone with Nate Warrick. Good night, Bruin Nation, from Bob Jones University.
We first and foremost look for good team chemistry and build that team chemistry. That, to me, is probably the fundamental, most important thing we could do as a soccer team first and foremost, is making sure that, you know, they really become almost instantaneous best friends. And I think that has a lot to do with the way the girls treat each other with respect and just with an openness to basically bring new girls into the program and immediately accept them into the whole program. So I think certainly, you know, we do need players that can play this game. Maybe they played either high-level club soccer or they played high school. But we need girls that can basically edify and encourage each other first and foremost.
And I think even for us, the leaders, this past year, they did a great job of reminding all of us, you know, our primary goal to magnify Christ in what we're doing. So trying, making sure we're keeping things in perspective as we're putting our best effort forth on the field, in every other area, in academics, in every area, how can we magnify Christ?
For us, it's demanding nothing but the best effort every time we train. You know, we just try to go into every training session with the attitude that this is game related. It's not just a drill. This is part of preparation for the matches to come. So I think it's really just a demand for the very best effort. And certainly that sometimes takes encouragement by the coach. It certainly takes encouragement by the players as well. I think the players give each other the best motivation when a practice is kind of grueling, kind of physically tough, and they just keep encouraging each other. And I think for our program, I think we try to build a culture where, again, the girls, they're not going to get screamed at and yelled at. They're going to get encouraged to be the best players they can become. And that means they have to be mentally focused during practice. There's also the fun side. You know, it's a great experience to be together with a bunch of people that love the game that you love so much. And I think there certainly is the light side of the game as well that they get to participate in as well.
Our guys, they want to be challenged. You know, they want to be pushed. You know, so we'll certainly still have fun. It'll be relaxing at times, and every nouncing in our joke with them or our smile, and they'll be looking at me like, Coach, we don't know if you're serious or you're kidding right now. So we have a good time with the guys. You know, the road trips are fun, time working out, times at practice, and every now and again we'll change something up at practice and do something a little bit different, keep things exciting and interesting and fun. But we certainly want to push players just beyond a little bit what they're comfortable with. You know, if they're constantly coming out to practice and they're always comfortable, they're not really being challenged. So if you're comfortable with a specific technique or concept or whatever, how can we push you just beyond that comfort level to really push you to excel?
I think along that line, I think we have, at least on both teams, we have very, I think, elite-minded players. They love the game, they're passionate about it, and they really desire to become better players individually so that they can help the team as a whole. And most importantly, they do this for not only the team, but they do it for God's glory, and they really enjoy every facet of what they're doing as a team player within these programs.
The team excitement, a lot of it stems from leadership on the team. Whether we're up by goals or we're down by a few goals, regardless of how much time is on the clock, just that energy and that confidence that spills over from one player to the next. And when every player has that mentality, it's a positive thing. And having leaders on the team that are consistently doing that is vital to the success of the program.
We've got a new enough program right now that the excitement's still there, but it's really up to now the coaches and the teams to now start playing at a higher level. So as we become more competitive and that the higher level competition, I think, will start driving continued excitement that I think the community has. But overall, we get great support from our BJU alumni and students and just the community at large. It's been a phenomenal experience, and I'm fairly confident that we're going to continue to see these supporting crowds and excitement that we see along with it. I think every coach has to have their own philosophy in how they're going to basically lead, how they're going to coach. Every coach is different. I'm gonna be what Christ would be to his disciples as far as, you know, in the coaching world. And it's more than just coaching. It's basically being a mentor, and it's certainly just being a friend when they need one. But can we take the players and keep them encouraged, build them, and just making sure that we're meeting all their needs?
It's certainly something constantly have to remind myself and ask myself, you know, what's my point in life? You know, if kids come here and they get a great education and they graduate and they're better at soccer, but I haven't taught them anything else, you know, again, by God's grace and through his leading, then what am I doing with my life? So that's one reason I'm into coaching. I've had coaches that have impacted my life, and it's a great privilege and opportunity to impact the lives of other young men. But I think students, as are looking, considering schools, you know, where does God want them at? Just again, fantastic facilities, fantastic education, and that desire. And it's certainly a Christian environment where we desire students that want to come here and want to grow in their walk with Christ. It's not that it's kind of sort of important, like soccer's the most important and the Christian values are kind of sort of important. You know, we want to strive to be excellent both with soccer and in challenging individuals to follow after Christ with their whole heart.
Man, I tell you what, this place is awesome. I mean, it's a great place to be, and I know our players really enjoy it.